Hello everyone, I am Professor Amit Vyas, Computer IT Department from Dr. Subhash Technical Campus. Today, we are discuss about mobile computing and wireless communication. Previous lecture, we are cover what is the OSI model. You know that what is the OSI model and how many layers in the OSI model. So we can start. Our next topic is TCP/IP model. So this is the OSI model. You know that here we can briefly some introduction of the OSI model. You also know that, but we can start some TCP/IP, the importance of the OSI model. So in OSI model have a 7 layer: physical layer, data link layer, network layer, transport layer, session layer, and presentation layer. You know that. Then what is the use of the physical layer and all the layers? We can cover the previous lecture. So physical layer mostly used in the bits, and it means our data will be formed in a bits form. Then after, what is the frame, and then what is the packet and transport layer, then presentation and application layer. We all the know that. So we can start the next. Also we can know that this is the importance of the OSI model. You know that what is the physical layer, data link layer, and network layer is a low layer, and transport layer is a heart of the OSI model. Then this is the three layer is a upper layer. So this is the some explanation of the what is the physical layer. You know that the fiber and wireless and hub and repeater used for the physical layer. Then what is the data link layer? You know that the organized into frame, it is used for the data link layer. Then what is the network? Network mostly used for the packet from source to destination is provide the interface and interconnection between network in the network layer. Then what is the transport layer? So the transport layer is a heart of the OSI model to provide the reliable process to process and message deliver information from source to destination with some error message or any other message. Then what is the session? You know that your online ATM transaction is a process of the session. Then what is the presentation layer? It is a one used for the translate, encryption, and compression of the data, mostly used in the presentation layer. And what is the application? All the allowed to access the network resources, it is used for the application layer. So this is one short description of the OSI model. So we can start. The next is TCP/IP model. So what is the TCP/IP model and what is the main difference between OSI model and TCP/IP model? We can show that. So this is one explanation short of the TCP/IP model. Here the TCP/IP model have a 4 layer, not a 5. So the TCP/IP model have a 4 layer. We can know that the application layer, host to host or transport layer, you know that. Then internet layer and network interface layer. So this is the diagrams of the TCP/IP reference model. First of all, you can draw this is the TCP/IP diagram. Also you can write here OSI model, because of the this is the comparison you easily write and explain for any particular field. So we can start TCP/IP reference model. So transmission control protocol, it is called the TCP/IP protocol. And what is the IP internet protocol? So transmission control protocol and TCP/IP protocol is used in the engine for the internet and network worldwide. This TCP/IP is a combined some OSI layer into the single layer, or does not use certain player at all. So what is the TCP/IP? TCP/IP is a combination of the OSI model. You know that. Or we can use for combination use of the some of the layer. TCP/IP is a set of protocol developed to allow cooperating the computer to share the resources across the network. So this is one short explanation of the TCP/IP reference model. So we can start. TCP/IP have a four layer. First is application. Second is host to host or transport layer. Third is internet layer. And fourth is network interface layer. So we can start. This is the diagrams of the TCP/IP model. You know that here four layer you can show. So what is the network interface layer? So the network interface layer is a combination of the physical layer and also data link layer. Some parts. Then you can show that this is the network layer and internet layer. Transport layer is also in host to host and transport layer. And remaining three layer is a combine of application layer. So what is the used of the TCP/IP? We can show that. So the network interface layer is mostly work in Ethernet, Docker ring and frame and ATM machine. Then what is the ARP? We can show the internet layer and what is the IP internet protocol and IGMP and ICMP. So the next is a host to host and transport layer. We can show the TCP and UDP transmission control protocol and user defined protocol. And finally application layer, you can show the FTP, SMTP, DNS and all the telnet and all the services of the OSI model. So we can start. What is the application layer? The application layer is provided by the program that use the TCP/IP for the communication. It means the application layer use the process of operating with another process, usually on the different host. For example, they have also benefit to the application communication within a single host. For example, Telnet and FTP mostly use in application layer. So the what is the transport layer? So the transport layer provides the end-to-end data transfer by delivering the data from application to the remote peer. Multiple applications can be supported simultaneously. The most used the transport layer protocol is the transmission control protocol, which is provide connection oriented and reliable data services, duplicate data, suspension, congestion control and flow control. So what is the importance? We can show the TCP and UDP. This is the both used in the transport layer. So the TCP mostly used provide the services for the connection oriented and reliable data delivery, duplication of the data and congestion control and flow control. This is the importance is provided in the transport layer for the TCP. Then another transport layer is a UDP. It means user datagram protocol. Connection less and unreliable services is provided for the UDP. Best effort services is provided the UDP. So also you can the comparison, you know that, or check that the TCP and UDP. So what is the comparison between TCP and UDP? Also UDP is used by the application that need the fast transport mechanism and can tolerate the loss of the some data. So this is the transport layer. Transport layer mostly used TCP and UDP. It means the connection oriented services and connection less services. So this is the transport layer. So now next we can show the internetwork layer. You know that this is the internet layer also. The interwork layer, also called internet layer or network layer. It is provide virtual network image or internet. This layer seated the higher level from the physical network. You can architecture, you can show that. It means this is the upper layer of the network interface layer or host layer or down of the host layer. So, internet protocol is most important part of the this layer. It is connectionless protocol that does not assume reliability for the low layer. IP does not provide reliability, flow control, or error control. IP provide routing function that attempt to deliver the transmission message to the destination. This message unit is a IP network. It is called the IP datagram. So, what is the example of the internet work layer? You can show that what is internet protocol. So, this is the IP, it means internet protocol, and then ICMP, internet control message protocol, then IGMP, internet group management protocol, and then what is the ARP, address resolution protocol, and reverse address resolution protocol. It is called the RAP. So this is the work of the internet layer. Now we can show the network interface. It means you can show that network interface layer. Also you can use physical layer in details. So the network interface layer is also called the link layer or data link layer or host to network layer. So the network interface is a many name. You can show that a link layer, data link, or host to network layer. It is the interface to the actual network hardware. This is the interface may or may not be provide reliable delivery and may be packet or stream oriented. So mostly network interface is mostly connected in the hardware of the network, and it is not provide the reliable delivery or maybe packet or some information or data link. For example, IEEE standard from the packet X2.25 or some ATM or all the interface is example of the network interface layer. Now we can show physical network layer. This is the combination of the network interface. Also you can not write this is the physical layer. It is also be possible. This is also combination of the network interface and physical. So the physical network layer is specify the characteristic of the hardware to be used the network. For example, it is specify the physical characteristic of the communication media is a standard such of IEEE 802.3. So what is the communication standard? It is the standard of IEEE and the standard is for 802.3. Also, the IEEE communication is provided in the specification of the Ethernet network media and RS-232. The specification for the standard pin will be connector. So physical layer mostly use the connection of the hardware and networking. So what is the physical network? Physical network layer is specify the characteristic of the hardware to be used some network. So mostly IEEE standard we can use for the physical connection or the network information. Then RS-232 specific standard pin, you can use the physical layer. So this is the physical layer. Also you can show that the network interface layer. So this is the four layer of the TCP/IP model. One is a network interface layer. You can start in the here. Then internet layer, host to host layer, and application layer. So what is the used? This is network interface is used from Ethernet. Then internet is used the IP and ICMP. Then transport layer mostly work in TCP and UDP. And application is all the application and services also use some suitable protocols in the application layer. So this is the TCP/IP model. You can know that. Next we can start. What is the communication network? You know that what is the communication we can use for the real-time application. You know that what is the LAN, main, and WAN. But we can explain one short for the what is the LAN, main, and WAN. First of all, we can show what is the communication. Communication is a simplify that. The transferring the information from one place, person, or group to any other place, person, or group. So we can simple, we can say that if you transfer from information from one to another, it is called the communication. The size of the network can be expressed by the geographical area. So the geographical area is the importance of the communication network. We can show what is the LAN, main, and WAN. So we can start. What is the LAN? It means local area network. So this is the diagrams of local area network. You have created on your diagrams for any particular local area network. How can you communicate to each other based on the LAN? It is privately owned network within a single building or a campus up to few kilometer in a size. Mostly local area network is established within a 1 kilometer or a few kilometers. So mostly interconnected network or privately owned for in particular area, it is called the local area network. They are widely used to connect the person computer and workstation in a company, office, and factory to share the resources. For example, printer and exchange the information. So what is the local area network? The mostly local area network is connected at one company or any office. And one printer, it is used for the shared resources. For example, this is you can show this is one company place, and here number of computer which are connected with one cable, and this is one printer. So you assume that this is one printer, and then after one system is connected, all the system use for the sharing information, and this printer you have print out or any other system easily because of the data or cable you can share. So mostly in office used for a local area network because the information will be easily to share for any system or access any other system easily for the data sharing. Exchange information and the resource sharing is an importance. For example, we can show that one printer is connected in a LAN cable. Now all the system which are used this printer. So resource sharing is an importance for the local area network. LAN are easy to design and troubleshoot. So LAN is easy to design. If you use one cable and you have connect of 10 to 15 PC or printer and share the resources. And also you have some problems for any cables or any system, then you can easy to find out. So this is the use of the local area network. Now we can some explanation. In LAN, all the mechanism are connect to the single cable. Different types of topology such a bus, ring, star, and tree are used. The data rate of the LAN mostly 4 to 60 Mbps. So the, what is the LAN? LAN mostly single cable you have used for the data sharing. This is one Ethernet cable you mostly used. And the you can mostly use bus topology. So each and every device which are connected to each other for any one network. Then the speed, the data rate, it means the internet speed is mostly 4 to 60 Mbps is in the cable. So transfer the data at high speed for the bandwidth. The existing in the limited geographical area. So what is the limitation of the LAN? Mostly geographical area is very small. So and the data rate is high because of the number of system which are connected is less. Connectivity and resources, especially the transmission media, usually are managed by the company which is running to the LAN. So the connectivity and resource sharing is an importance for the local area network, and data transmission speed is very high. So mostly used in a personal or one office or a cable or any campus for the local area network. So this is the LAN is a first part of the communication network. So next we can show what is the main metropolitan area network. Now main network is covered one city. The best known example of the main is a cable television network is available in the many city. So mostly main is used for the any particular city or area. Main is basically bigger version for the LAN. Because of LAN is mostly used some office or 1 kilometers area or geographical area is very less in use in the LAN. But main is mostly used many number of cities which are connected, and this is called the main. The main is basically bigger version for LAN and normally similar the technology. The technology is similar, but the area or geographical size we can cover is higher compared to LAN. The first, the company begin jumping into the business, gathering some contact from city or government to the wire up entire city. So we can show this is one factory and one warehouse or other branch in other city, and this is the branch office or this is one central office. It is called the one networks which is connected. It is called the one main. So what is the main? You have connect one city to another. For example, Ahmedabad to Baroda, you have connected one television networks or any other LAN cable or television cable or any other internet connectivity. So this is called the main area network. The next step of the television programming and even entire channel is designed for the cable only. Offer this channel wire. Highly specify search all the news, all the sports and all the cookings as soon as one central office. It means the data transmission for any particular place to another which is widely used for the geographical area. So main is the same work for the LAN, but the area connection is very large compared to the LAN. So this is the main. You can show that. Then next we can show what is the WAN, wide area network. WAN is mostly used the large geographical area, often by the country or containers. It contains a collect of the mechanisms intended for the running user. It means of any programs. We will follow the traditional use and call this mechanism to the host. So what is the main? We can show this diagrams. This is the diagrams of the WAN wide area network. So what is the use of the wide area network? WAN is mostly large geographical area which is connect to each other for any country or any other resources. We saw that here one India, London and America, which are connect to each other based on the some information sharing based on the WAN wide area network. So all the data you have share for one country to another country, then it is used for the wide area network. So this is the image of the WAN, and also we can show one government to government or one network to another network, which one country to another country or in a country is mostly used the WAN technology. So this is the WAN, it means wide area network. Then we can show the last, the host are connect by the communication subnet or just subnet for the short path. It means mostly country to country is referred for the WAN, but also in one country you have connect one WAN to another WAN for any network to another network. Also it is called the WAN. It is the wide area network. So here we can show one short explanation of the wide area network. The communication between different user for the WAN is established using telephonic line or satellite link and similar channel. So what is the explanation of this paragraph? The communication between telephonic line. So mostly you can use the telephonic line in one country to one country or one country to another country. That time you can wait particular signal or connection, because mostly used in the satellite link, or you can live show for any particular sports or any channel. A similar link is provided for the particular network. So this is the wide area network. So we can show the communication network in a three types: LAN, MAN and WAN. Also you can comparison of the what is the LAN, MAN and WAN, and which is the parameters is compared to each other is mostly you can write that for the communication network. So also you can compare all the LAN, MAN and WAN, which functionality we have common or particular network. So we can show that here all, this is the OSI model, you can show that. Then after, this is the one explanation for the OSI model. Then we can show TCP/IP model. In TCP/IP model is a four layer. So this is the four layer, you can show that. Then we can show all the functional application of the TCP/IP model. Then next we have show about the what is the communication network. It means the LAN, MAN and WAN. So thank you all of you.